In this video, we are going to see what are the basic types of handoff or handover. To begin with handoff, let's first understand what is a cellular phone. A cellular telephone is basically a two-way walkie-talkie that acts like a telephone. With a walkie-talkie, you either talk or you listen. With a cell phone, you can talk and listen at the same time. You can dial a number to place a call, you can receive calls. You can do fancy things like three-way calls, conference calls, call hold and voicemail. As you can see in this picture, two vehicles use the same frequency but only one party can talk at a time like in walkie-talkie. This type of communication is called as simplex radio. In this picture, two transmitters use different frequencies, so both the parties can talk at the same time. This type of communication is called as duplex radio. Cell phones are duplex. Always remember, a cell phone is a radio. Now, what is a cellular system? Consider one city. In the cellular phone system, the city is divided into smaller sections or cells. Each cell contains its own antenna and uses only a subset of all the channels. Each antenna is lower in height and emits a much weaker signal so that the same subset of channels can be used in a cell somewhere else within the city. For example, within a typical cellular system, every seventh cell uses the same set of channels. What is handoff? Mobility is the most important feature of a wireless cellular communication system. Usually, a continuous service is achieved by supporting handoff or handover from one cell to another. Handoff is the process of changing the channel, that may be frequency, time slot, spreading code or combination of them, associated with the current connection while a call is in progress. For explanation, consider two adjacent cells, cell A and cell B, each having its own antenna whose frequencies are different. Consider a vehicle in cell A which is connected to the base station antenna, which means that mobile phone in cell A uses the frequency of cell A for communication. When vehicle moves from cell A to cell B, the mobile phone has to switch from frequency of cell A to frequency of cell B. As soon as vehicle enters into cell B, it will start using frequency of cell B for communication. The process of switching of frequency from cell A to cell B is called as handoff. Sometimes it is also called as handover.
Why there is a need of handoff? First point is power consideration. Second point is traffic consideration. Third is the channel quality consideration. Fourth point is distance consideration. And the last point is administrative consideration. First point in need of handoff is power consideration. Consider a person is in one cell. He is communicating with another person by using the signal coming from the antenna of a cell. For example, if the signal strength or the power received by the mobile system is -67 dB, then the power received by the mobile system is good and thus there is no need of handoff. But if the power received by the mobile system starts decreasing, then the chances of handoff increases. As here, if the strength becomes -102 dB, then the signal will become weak and it will be difficult to maintain the call. In this case, the mobile needs to find another signal whose strength is high. Thus, there is a need of handoff when power level decreases below certain threshold level. Second point is traffic consideration. Ideally, available channels would have equal number of subscribers active at one time. There is a limit in a cell that how many subscribers can use frequency of a cell. If there is limited number of users in a cell, then a single base station transceiver can handle calls simultaneously. But if number of users increases in a cell and if the number goes beyond the threshold value, then to accommodate those users, it is necessary to find another antenna so that the extra users can communicate by using antenna of other cells. Thus, according to the capacity of base station, it is necessary to decide how many users can accommodate in a cell, which is important for handoff in mobile communication. Third is channel quality consideration. In this point, we are trying to show that the quality of the signal reaching the mobile phone is different. If the quality of the signal is good and if it is continuous, then there is no need of handoff. And if the quality of the signal is not good, means if there is discontinuity in the signal reaching the phone due to various reasons like obstacles in between user and antenna, or poor radiating quality of antenna, or if due to faulty antennas, then there is a need of transition of one signal from one cell to another. In this way, channel quality consideration can be considered while performing handoff. Fourth point is distance consideration. In a cell, when a person is moving away from the base station antenna, signal strength decreases, that means the signal becomes weak. Near the antenna, person gets strongest signal. There is no problem in his or her communication. But as soon as the distance becomes from the antenna increases, signal becomes weaker and weaker. And at one point, if the person crosses the boundary of the cell, he or she loses the signal from the base station. So it becomes necessary to find another antenna which is nearer to the person. Thus, distance is also an important factor in handoff, which decides which antenna to be used for communication. Last is administrative consideration. Maintenance of antenna is required for good performance. Because of this reason, sometimes it is necessary to turn off the antenna. In this case, user from that particular cell needs to be transferred to the nearest base station transceiver, or sometimes if there is a problem in the antenna, it is necessary to detect the problem, then work on the problem to bring it to the original state. It is necessary to turn off the antenna. Thus, due to maintenance and due to defect in the antenna, we should transmit all the users from the cell to another means. Handover is required in this case. Basically, handoffs are classified into two types. First is hard handoff. Second is soft handoff.
What is hard handoff? Handoff in which the link to the prior base station is terminated before or as the user is transferred to the new cell's base station, the mobile phone is linked to no more than one base station at any given time is called as hard handoff. Hard handoff is primarily used in FDMA, that is frequency division multiple access, and TDMA, that is time division multiple access, where different frequency ranges are used in adjacent channels in order to minimize channel interference. So, when the mobile phone moves from one cell to another cell, it becomes impossible for it to communicate with antennas of both cells since different frequencies are used. As shown earlier in the definition of handoff, there were two cells A and B. Similarly, consider there are two cells A and B, each having antenna at the center of the cell. When vehicle is in cell A, it is connected to the base station antenna of cell A. When the vehicle moves towards the boundary of the adjacent cells, mobile phone loses connection from both the cells. There is no link in mobile system and base station antenna of either cell. And as soon as vehicle moves in cell B, mobile phone gets connected to the base station of antenna of cell B. Hard handover is also called as break before make. Advantages of hard handover are as follows. Only one channel is occupied at a time. It is very short and usually is not perceptible by the user. In hard handoff, the phone hardware does not need to be capable of receiving two or more channels in parallel, which makes it cheaper and simpler. There could be a problem in hard handover, that is, if we are downloading one file in one cell and if we move from that cell to another, then the downloading would be obstructed. But if we move in another cell, instead of downloading the file from beginning, it starts from the point where it had stopped. This is because while downloading data in previous cell, it stores the data in buffer in main station, and as soon as we come in the next cell, it restores the data from the main station and starts downloading further.
What is soft handoff? Handoff in which the connection with the target station is made before the connection with the source is broken is called as soft handover. Soft handoff in mobile cellular network technology is commonly used in CDMA, that is code division multiple access, that enables the overlapping of the repeater coverage zones so that every phone set is always well within the range of at least one of the base station. Since channel in multiple cells are maintained, possibility of call failure is only due to the effect of interference of fading at a time. Also, the fading and interference are highly unrelated to the channels so that the probability of their existence at the same time is very less. Thus, finally prevents the call from disruption or abnormal termination. Here also consider there are two cells A and B, each having antennas at the center of the cell. When vehicle is in cell A, it is connected to the base station antenna of cell A. When the vehicle moves towards the boundary of the adjacent cells, mobile phone maintains its connection with both the cells. It establishes link in mobile systems and the base station antenna of both the cells. And as soon as the vehicle moves in cell B, mobile phone gets connected to the base station antenna of cell B. Soft handover is also called as make before break. Advantages of soft handover are as follows. There is change in frequency or timing due to the mobility of user so that there are practically no dead zones. It possesses more reliable continuity in networking with very less chance of call termination than that of hard handoff. Before going to softer handover, which is a subpart of soft handover, let us first see what is sectorization in cellular networks. Because of the increasing demand for the wireless services, the available channels within the cells become insufficient to support the growing number of the users. To increase the system capacity, techniques such as sectoring may be implemented. In sectoring, the cell is divided into three parts. It can be divided into more, but due to the cost effectiveness, it is divided into three parts. Here, the base station contains three antennas facing in particular direction. That means, instead of radiating in all directions, it radiates in one particular direction, thus directivity increases. These sectors are known as alpha sector, beta sector, and gamma sector. What is softer handover? As discussed earlier, handoff occurs when the person moves from one cell to another. But in case of softer handoff, handoff occurs when person moves in the same cell site. Here, handoff takes place between the sectors of the cell when the person moves from alpha sector to beta sector to gamma sector, or gamma sector to alpha sector. Now, in softer handoff, you can see that a vehicle is traveling in its own cell site but passes through various sectors. This transition from one sector to another does not affect the ongoing call. This is because of softer handover. We hope that our video has helped you to learn all about handoffs in mobile communication systems. Thank you.